I am going to teach you how to earn rupees 40,000 to 50,000 in a span of 3 to 5 days. So how to earn that? How to earn that? First, you should become a chartered accountant. Next, you should know how to incorporate a company. So now, don't read this incorporation provisions as a procedure. It's an income generating avenue. You will not know how much time the chartered accountant spend for incorporation of a company. Zero. Article assistants, they do every work with respect to incorporation of the company, mere procedural formalities. But still, how much we charge? We charge minimum 35,000, 40,000 to 50,000. Normal firms, normal firms. Konja relatively big firms means what they will do? There are some 4 to 5 forms to be filed. For filing one form, they will charge 20,000. Then, for going to the ROC, for every sitting with the particular firm manager, they will charge amount. There are some firms which are charging as high as 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs for incorporation. So minimum assured is 40,000. If you get at least 10 company incorporation, at least 4 lakhs is assured. Adu mattum illa, 10 companies incorporate every year, that 10 companies auditor, you will be the auditor of all those 10 companies. So you have some recurring revenue income also. Sorry. Now, LAC agent. Now I am going to teach you how to incorporate a company. But the saddest part is, you need to learn this incorporation procedure, by heart this incorporation procedure, write this incorporation procedure, forget this incorporation procedure, because I am going to teach you incorporation procedure as per 1956. But today what is applicable in practice is 2013 incorporation procedure. However, the overall incorporation procedures tend to be the same. Inge I call it as particular form, here it will be different form. Form numbers will undergo a change, but the overall incorporation procedure steps will remain the same. Now tell me, first stop this begging activity. Sir, sir, I am not taking you coaching to beg. Pichakaram, mari amma, daye, amma, sir, sir. Stop this begging activity. Now, from next class onwards, I will bring a packet full of coins. Somebody you say, sir, I will throw it on you. Now, as professionals, you should make others beg before you. You shall not beg before anyone. Right. Now listen. Now friends, you tell me, what is the procedure for incorporating a company? Whatever you know, tell. Number one, promoter should decide what is the nature of company, what is the nature of business to be carried on in that particular company, in which state, in which state the company is going to be incorporated, with what capital the company is to be incorporated, who are all going to be the directors of the company, where the office of the company is situated. All these things first the promoters, they should think even before coming to a chartered accountant. Respond, friends. Sorry. Now what is the procedure? Number one, promoters will decide all these things. Then they should decide three names. They should decide three. Can I form, I am going to form a company in real estate. Can I name it as RM Real Estates Limited? Can I name it as RM Real Estates Limited? Why? No. Huh. I am going to be 8%. My relatives, my friends, 8%. We are going to incorporate this company. Can I form it as RM Real Estate Private Limited or RM Real Estate Limited? Yes, possible. Can I just form it as RM Limited or RM Private Limited? Can I just, without using the business name in my company name, can I form a company?
Yes.
Possible or not possible?
Yes.
Sorry, suppose this is Mahesh Tutorials Limited. Could it have been incorporated as Mahesh Limited?
Yes.
Possible or not possible?
Yes.
Possible. Very much possible. Appo, you can either incorporate a company by mentioning the business name also in the company, or you can incorporate a company without mentioning the business. Question number one. Why should I select names? Company should have names. Company should have name. There should be identity. Adhukaga I should select name. Why three names? Pinky, Pinky, Ponky. Sorry, why three names? Come on, tell me. Thank you, sir. Listen. I am starting a company by name. Useless Limited. Assume, yeah. I am starting a company by name Useless Limited. What happens? In Hyderabad, one person is already has started a company by name Useless Limited and is running the company for the past 10 years. In Rajasthan, one more person has started a company by name Useless Limited. For the past 15 years, he has been carrying on that company. Come on, friends.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I also try to form a company Useless Limited, this is conflicting with the name of existing company. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
But thereby, I need to select three names. All these three names, I will give it to the ROC. All these three names, I will give it to the
ROC.
Whichever name is available, ROC will allot that name to me. I need to file E-Form 1A with the ROC. And the E-Form 1A, like three names I would have written. I need to file E-Form 1. Will you stop those murmurings? What form I need to file? I need to file E form 1. Any form I file it with the ROC should be supported by a Dakshina. 500 rupees Dakshina I should keep here. So E form 1A along with, this is over the table. Not under the table. Over the table. Under the table will come if you don't get the desired name. Intentionally name number 1 you put, he will not allot name number 1, he will allot name number 2. Appa, you need to go and meet the ROC. You need to provide sweet packets to him. A gift, yeah, not bribe. Bottles. Gift.
Bottles.
Bottles, sir. Cool drinks. Cool drinks, etc. You may have to provide to him. Hi. Anyways. Buddhi oda nirthiko. Now listen. Hippo. Hey, come on, tell me, friends. What form should be filed with the ROC?
E-Form
1A. Adu kuda how much dakshina?
500.
Now, listen, listen. Just listen to me. ROC will allot the name. After ROC allots the name to me, this name will be available for some specified number of period. Within that period, I should incorporate the company. But once the ROC is allotted the name to me, I should plunge into action. I should prepare the memorandum of association. I should prepare the articles of association. Up in the memorandum of association, what informations will be there, or what is the step for preparing memorandum of association? Following steps are there. Number one, drafting. Number one is drafting. Number two is vetting. Number two is vetting. Wetting, now what you should do? Prepare the MOA, AOA. Pour water. And the wetting illa. This is VETTING. This is wetting. Cutting illa. What is this wetting? Wetting now proofreading. Come on, what is meant by wetting? Next, listen. Next is stamping. Next is stamping. Some stamp duty should be paid. Next is called as signing. I will not repeat this. Come on, listen. Next is called as signing. This signing is also called as subscribing to MOA. Signing of MOA is also called as subscribing to MOA. And the persons who are signing this MOA, they are called as subscribers to MOA. Come on, tell me. Signing, that process is called as subscribing to MOA. Persons who are doing that signing activity, they are called as subscribers to MOU. Next, there should be a witness. This is a process with respect to memorandum of association and articles of association. Come on, tell me, what is the process with respect to MOA and AOA? Number one,
drafting.
Number two, vetting. Number three, stamping. Number four, signing. Other name in subscribing to the MOA. Persons who are signing, they are called as subscribers to MOA. And the last one is witness. The same procedure for articles of association also. Same procedure for articles of association also. Appa enna procedure for articles of association? Drafting, vetting, stamping, signing,
witness.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
You know, one more point if you want na, drafting, vetting, appra printing ni setuko. It should be drafted, draft copy, then all the unnecessary things are weeded out, then printing. So drafting, vetting, printing, stamping, signing, witness. Chale. Now closely follow. How this MOA should be? Should it be handwritten or can it be printed? Handwritten or printed? So it can either be handwritten or it can be printed. Normally nowadays it is in printing. But one thing to be understood, subscribers to the MOA, signing portion alone should be in handwritten. That's why it's signing. It is called as typing. So signing, it should be handwritten. Now when the subscriber to the MOA is signing, what he should do? He should write his name. He should write his address. He should write his occupation. He should write the number of shares he is taking. And then he should put a signature. Understand, all these things are to be done handwritten. Name will be written there. I will go and put my signature. No. Name, address, occupation, number of shares, signature. Idellame should be in handwritten form.
Yes, sir.
Whose handwritten form? Respective person's handwritten form. Ellathiyum I write and then I ask them to put the signature alone. No. Everyone should write their own name, their own address, their own occupation, their number of shares which are going to take, and they should put their signature. Respond.
Yes, sir.
This should take place both for memorandum of association as well as for articles of association. Ingyu handwritten, all these contents should be there. Ingyu handwritten, all these contents should be there. Next. Memorandum and articles put together, can a subscriber? No. You should subscribe separately to the memorandum of association. You should subscribe separately to the articles of association. Purunjuda?
Yes, sir.
Now, what I have got in hand? Memorandum of association, articles of association. And I also have got the name approval letter from the ROC. He has approved the name approval letter also, name allotment letter or name approval letter I am having. Next, one more step I should do. I should get a form called as form number 1. I should get a form called as form number 1. What is this form number 1? This is a declaration. This form is a
declaration.
This is a declaration that all the procedures with respect to incorporation has been complied with. Abrinu a declaration is given. Who is giving this declaration? It can be given either by an advocate of the High Court or by an advocate of the Supreme Court. Or it can be an attorney or pleader of High Court. That was an old concept. That concept is not there. So advocate of High Court or an advocate of Supreme Court. Or it can be by a
chartered
accountant in practice. Or it can be by a company secretary. Or it can be by a director or manager or secretary who is involved in the incorporation of the company. Story is only one thing. The bottom line of the story is, ROC cannot come and verify each and every company whether they have complied with the provisions of the act, because in each day many number of companies they get incorporated. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
So they are just passing the responsibility. How are they passing the responsibility? Get a declaration in form number 1 that we have complied with all the provisions with respect to incorporation of the company. And the form number 1 declaration yaar kudukano? It can be either by an advocate by the advocate of the High Court or an advocate of Supreme Court, or it can be an attorney or pleader of a High Court, or it can be by a chartered accountant in practice, or it can be by a company secretary, or it can be by a director, manager or secretary who is involved in the formation of the company. Getting my point?
Yes,
any of these persons, any of these persons. Come on, once more tell me who are all those persons? Advocate of High Court. Don't look into the book and say it is of no use. Come on, tell me. Advocate of High Court or Supreme Court. Attorney or pleader of a High Court. Chartered accountant in practice or company secretary or by director or manager or secretary who is involved in the formation of the. Any of these idiots, they should give a declaration in form number 1. Next. Listen, 3 more forms are to be filed. Form number 29, form number 32, form number 18. What are all the 3 more forms to be filed? Come on, tell me. Form number 29, form number 32, form number 18. Form number 39, sorry, form number 29 is the consent of the directors. Is the consent of the directors. Why this consent of the directors? Closely follow. 3 or 4 persons who don't like me, they can form a company and they can include my name as a director, and the company may engage in unlawful activities. Suddenly one day ROC along with police will come to my home. You are a director in that company? No. I will ask first question, is there a company like that? Yes or not? Apo, to avoid this, when you are going to incorporate a company and if a person has consented to act as a director, he should file a form with the company that ROC that I am willing to act as a director of the company. Respond, friends.
Yes, sir.
Next, form number 32. Allah, what will be there? Details of the director. What is the director's name? What is his educational qualification? What is his surname? What is his address? What is his nationality? What is his residence? All this information, etc., should be given. Come on, friends. Sorry. Next, form number 18. Form number 18 is nothing but the address of the registered office of the company. Form number 18 address of the registered office of the company. Very simple. You say company is incorporated. Tomorrow government wants to communicate with you, where it will go and search. There should be some address of the company to whom the communications can be made, thereby form number 18, address of the registered office. All these forms you will take, plus one power of attorney, generally giving power to any one promoter or to a chartered accountant. Edukku? Generally, when I go to ROC, he will not complete the things in one day. So he will say, make this changes, make that changes, make this changes. But every time what may happen, I may have to take a lorry, I may have to just put in all the promoters and then I may have to go to the ROC. One day now, okay, every day if it happens, it is not good, it is not possible also. So give power of attorney to anyone, promoter or to a chartered accountant. Whatever changes he is making, that is binding on us. Give one, power of attorney. Similarly, to receive the certificate of incorporation, also give a power of attorney. These are all the overall procedures with respect to incorporation. File all these documents with ROC. ROC, it will incorporate the company. When you file all these documents with the ROC, ROC will incorporate the company. Are you all getting me, friends?
Yes.
Sir, come on, let us consolidate. Then I will display these slides to you. First, let us consolidate. We are going for a 3 to 4 step process. I am repeating twice. You are repeating once. We are seeing from this once, so we are going for such a process. Come on, tell me. And what is the procedure with respect to incorporation of company? First, Aadharam, root and promoter should decide all the things. What he should decide? Name of the company, place of the business, nature of the business, type of the business. Everything promoter should decide. Then he should prepare a form. What form? E-form 1. Engangala form or though, everything put it as E-form, except form number 1. Except form number 1. That is a manual form. On all the other places, put it as E form. Sorry. E form 1A. E form 1A edukku? Name availability. To check the name availability, E form 1A. Respond, friends.
Yes, sir.
E-form 1A, like, how many names are to be given?
Three.
Three names are to be given along with the dakshinai of
500
rupees. Sorry, out of this ROC will allot some name to you?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, all the three names are not available practically, what will happen? Again file E-form 1A, now fees is not there. Second time you can file E-form 1A, now second time fees is not there. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, now file E-form 1A, ROC will allot some name. Once ROC is allotting name to you, plunge into action. What are all the things you should prepare first? Memorandum of Association, Articles of Association. What are the steps involved in this Memorandum of Association, Articles of Association? Drafting, vetting, printing, stamping, signing, witness. Come on, repeat. What are all the steps which are involved?
Drafting.
Drafting, vetting, printing, stamping,
signing, witness.
Sorry. Signing of the Memorandum of Association is also called as
subscribing
to the Memorandum of Association. And the people who are subscribing to the Memorandum of Association, they are called as subscribers to the Memorandum of Association. MOA, AOA, should it be typed or should it be handwritten? Both possible. But one thing compulsory. What is that? Signing. Signing is compulsory. It should be in
handwritten
only. Signing both NNL and details are to be given.
Name,
address, occupation, number of shares, plus signature. It should be under your own hand. It should be under your own hand. Are you all getting my point?
Yes, sir.
It is the same story for Articles of Association also. Then prepare form number 1. What is form number 1?
Declaration.
What declaration? All the procedures have been complied with. For that, there is a declaration. That declaration is form number 1. Respond.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, in the declaration, who should sign this declaration? Advocate of a High Court or Supreme Court, or attorney or pleader of a High Court, or it can be by a chartered accountant, or by a company secretary, or by a director, or manager, or secretary, who is involved in the formation of the company. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, form 1 kuda micha other forms in 3 more forms. What are the forms? Form number 29, form number 32, form number 80. Form number 29, what will be there? Consent to act as director. Form number 32, what will be there?
Details
of the directors. Form number 18, what will be there? Address of the registered office. Plus power of attorney. All that you send it to ROC. Then incorporation will be done. Certificate of incorporation will be given. Everyone.
Yes, sir.
Now, practically one doubt. Sir, today only I am applying for incorporation. I don't have a registered office, sir. What can I do? You are asking me to file form number 18. What can I do? Or you mean to say that I should wait for incorporation till I get a registered office? You mean to say that I should wait for incorporation or I should wait for registered office to get incorporated? No. Now a privilege is given. What is that? Go for incorporation. Search for the registered office. Within 30 days of incorporation, if you file the form number 18, it is sufficient. Upon form number 18, if you have registered office at the time of incorporation, now itself file form number 18. No, sir. I don't have registered office at this point of time. Now what you can do is, within 30 days of incorporation, you can file form number 18. But point to be understood, if I am going to commence the business within this 30 days, on that date itself, I should have filed form number 18. Are you all with me? When you are going to commence the business, sir, today incorporation, tomorrow itself I am starting the business, now you should have filed form number 18. Before starting the business, you should have filed form number 18. Respond, friend.
Yes, sir.
No, sir. I am not going to immediately start the business. First, I should look for a registered office. Then only I am going to start the business. Now, within 30 days of incorporation, you should file this form number 8. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Honestly?
Yes, sir.
Can I?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what is the step number 1? Promoters to decide the name, place, type of company, etc. To file e-form 1A to check name availability. If name is available, ROC will give a NAL. MOA, AOA should be prepared. And then steps, drafting, vetting, printing, stamping, witness. Next. Documents to be filed with ROC in the MOA, AOA plus form number 1 plus name availability letter plus e-form 29, e-form 32, e-form 80 plus power of attorney. NAL means name availability letter. If you hand it over to the ROC, then you will get a certificate of incorporation. What if I don't do this? You will not get the company incorporated. 40,000 you will get. Sure enough. There is a new provision or a recent development by the ministry. We can very proudly say that one of the ministries across all the other ministries compared to excise, customs, income tax, etc. One of the ministries which is completely going the digital way is the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Almost everything is done in a digital way. Possibility or the outcome is to, number one, you need not go and wait for some persons to go and submit all the documents. Number two, bribe has come down substantially. Lena, if you go to get one form, adukuru bribe. If they want to give certificate of incorporation, adukuru bribe. Like these things were going on. Now, there is a newly introduced concept. Incorporating company within 24 hours. You can get the certificate of incorporation itself within 24 hours. For this, some procedures are to be followed. You file e-form number 1A with the ROC, yes or not?
Yes, sir.
That need not be filed with the ROC. Provided a professional gives a certificate. Professional, what certificate he should give? He should give a certificate. I have gone through the MCA website and the name of this proposed company is not similar to the name of any other company. I certify that I have gone through the MCA website and I did not find any identical name. Avinya, professional should certify. Now you get this professional certificate. File MOA, AOA, form number 1, form number 32, form number 29, form number 18, power of attorney, all these things you send it online. All these things you send it online. 24 hours plus certificate of incorporation will come online. 24 hours plus certificate of incorporation will come online. So this is a green initiative program undertaken by Ministry of Corporate Affairs to dispense with all these manual forms, etc., and for speedy activity of incorporation of a company, this is being done. In fact, almost all the forms, now they are e-forms, and any attachment, any additional information you need to give, scan and then send it out of them. No physical filing forms, no filing or keeping files, maintaining files, everything is available in database. Everything is available in your server, everything is available in your database. So this is the steps to be followed for incorporation of a company. One more small provision alone, I'll take. Everyone. Thank you, friends.